This is the all-new and first ever Hyundai Stargazer. And it's a South Korean automaker's rival to the likes of the Toyota Avanza, Mitsubishi Expander, just to name a few. Oh, and this is also their first time to enter the subcompact 7-seater MPV segment. And so with that in mind, how does the Stargazer stack up based on our first impressions? May kasabihan that first impressions last. At kung titingnan mo ang itsura nitong Hyundai Stargazer, mukha siyang pinaghalong Hyundai Staria at Mitsubishi Expander. But the overall impression is, the Stargazer looks very futuristic. So from the outset of the Hyundai Stargazer, una niyang mapapansin yung kanyang itong horizontal LED light bar, no? So, itong entire thing is actually the park lights, but if the car is in motion, this becomes the LED daytime running lights, itong nasa dalawang magkabilang dulo niya. Looks really striking, looks very futuristic, just like the Hyundai Staria, kung familiar kayo sa premium MPV na yon, or high ace rival kasi may cheaper variant ng Hyundai Staria, but I digress, no? So, apart from these striking LED light bar na to, you have ito pang separate headlight cluster niya. These are the main headlights talaga, by the way, LED beams, and then you have halogen fog lights. Looks really striking, and then ito yung kanyang grill, which also looks very futuristic kasi you have this parang modern mesh pattern. Then to make it sort of like an SUV or a crossover, you have this satin silver faux skid plate para meron nung parang SUV effect, though it's not an SUV, by the way, it's an MPV that rivals the Expander, the Veloz, Avanza, and all those vehicles, no? Down here, you have 17-inch alloy wheels. They also look really striking, very futuristic, and it really complements yung kanyang parang sort of bullet train vibe, kung sabihin natin. Looks really like a very modern, parang high-tech na high-speed train, no? I like the aesthetic of the Hyundai Stargazer. And then, down the sides, you have sculpting here do sa kanang lower part, you have these lines here, then meron kanong creases dito that stretch all the way to the back of the car. And then with the magic of video editing, we're now here at the back of the Hyundai Stargazer. So now yun nga, tong kanyang character line extends all the way to the taillights nga, which have this sort of Y-shape effect, no? It's really tall, ang tall ng kanyang taillights, by the way. The main taillight cluster aren't LED, but this thing, itong horizontal light bar niya tsaka itong vertical element are LEDs. They look really distinct at night. Sobrang guwapo niya and sobrang futuristic tingnan. And then you have the black pattern here that mimics the grill at the front. So basically yung front end niya and the rear end, they complement each other because they share more or less the same design theme, the design element, no? Then of course, Stargazer written here, the tailgate, and more of that satin silver faux skid plate effect. And yeah, the Hyundai Stargazer really looks very futuristic, very modern, and that's basically reflected when we go inside the car later, and as well as the features and the way it drives, which patigim pa lang to, but sabihin ko na agad, this is, I think, setting the benchmark ngayon in the subcompact entry-level MPV segment. What you're seeing here is the top-of-the-line GLS Premium. But the good news is, the mid-spec GLS largely mimics the aesthetic features of this variant, with the main advantage of getting the GLS Premium being its full suite of advanced driver assistance tech. And so dahil dyan, pag-usapan naman natin ang interior ng Hyundai Stargazer. So now that we're here inside the Hyundai Stargazer, you're gonna notice the very stylish interior for the class. So in terms of material quality, it's a lot of hard plastic pa rin. There's no soft touch plastics here whatsoever, unlike in the Expander. But styling wise, I think this is the best in its segment right now. So it looks very futuristic. And at the same time, hindi siya yung its style at the expense of practicality. So you have a dual layer shelf here, which
It's very flexible option in terms of practicality. So you have a lot of stuff for you, or you have a lot of storage at least for you to place your everyday items. And at the same time, this interior layout is actually very spacious. So I'm 5'11" here at the front of the Stargazer, and here in front of the Hyundai Stargazer. Yeah, the driving position is really great. I have plenty of space for my 5'11" height, so there's plenty of headroom. And what I like also is this is not common yet in the subcompact MPV segment, but you have a lot of adjustment for the steering wheel reach adjustment. Usually it's only rake yung kanyang angulo, no? So I'm happy to report that the Stargazer will provide you with an excellent driving position. So again, pati yung kanyang seats have a height adjustment then. Again, not common in the entry-level MPV segment, but yun nga, I am happy to report nga na it's easy to find your ideal driving position here in the Stargazer. As for functionality, so you have here a digital instrument cluster and an 8-inch touchscreen, by the way. And the touchscreen functionality is really well done. So it's a Hyundai OEM infotainment. This is one of those third-party infotainment that you would find normally in other brands, like in Suzuki, for instance. No, other brands have migrated to their own factory infotainment na rin. So for me, Hyundai's infotainment systems are one of the best in their segment because the icons are logically laid out. Ang laki ng kanyang mga on-screen buttons, no? So, and at the same time, you have wireless Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, which in conjunction with the wireless charging pad, you can truly use smartphone mirroring ng wireless ang hindi ka naubos ng baterya sa phone mo. Kasi if you do wireless Apple CarPlay and Android Auto nang walang wireless charger, it will easily drain your battery. But then again, kung gusto mong i-charge siya with the cable, well, it defeats the purpose of having wireless smartphone mirroring, di ba? Anyhow, the seats are also really nice. They're upholstered in synthetic leather, and I also like the fact that Hyundai has preferred using silver trims as opposed to gloss black that you would normally find in other vehicles. So not only does it look nicer, but more importantly, it resists fingerprints nga yung kanyang mga silver finishes na to. So really well done for Hyundai. I like the interior so much. It's, I think, currently the best, the benchmark in the segment in terms of both design and practicality. And then as for the rear seats, you're gonna see later na again, it's very spacious for my 5'11 height. There's plenty of room there at the back. And you know what? I also like the fact that you have a table which feels like you're traveling first class or business class in an aircraft, which is what you wouldn't find yet in this segment, no? Wala ka pang mga tables with other MPVs. So Hyundai is basically pushing the boundaries in terms of practicality and feature content with their Stargazer. Whew! Di ko sabing Stargazer. And now, as for the other practicality aspects, you have a huge trunk at the back. These are the numbers that you need to take note of. Yung kanang space in liters. And yeah, the Stargazer is really impressive in terms of practicality and feature content, as mentioned kanina. And this leads me on to talk about the car's drive experience then. So now that we've hit the open road with the Hyundai, okay, not open road, but inside the village, because this car hasn't been launched yet as we're filming. The Hyundai Stargazer, yes, buti sabi ko Stargazer. The Hyundai Stargazer performs really well on the road. So at least on our first impressions with the Stargazer, the car feels really solidly built, feels rigid. I really care about rigidity kasi cars in this segment tend to feel a bit wallowy sa kanang structure. But here in the Stargazer, I like the structure of the vehicle, so you don't have much in terms of vibrations, you don't have much in terms of flexing kapag, let's say, you're going through bumps. And we haven't taken this out on high speeds yet because, well, this car hasn't been launched nga, so as if naman we're gonna be able to drive this out on the open road, no? So at least here in these speeds, maganda yung refinement niya. There's not a lot of wind and road noise. It feels really quiet. It feels really subdued in terms of noise. With that in mind, this car will, at least again, in my first impressions, it will seem to be like a good long distance cruisers. So I'm really keen to take this car out on the open road to see how it performs in terms of stability out on the highway. But here in terms of handling, since that's what we're gonna be able to test ngayon pa lang, it has a CVT by the way, and let's push these corners. The car handles tidily, and dahil kong gamit sa likod, I'm so sorry. The car handles tidily. It's not what you would call fun in let's say a sporty subcompact car like a Mazda 2. Okay, they're in the same segment, pero at least para kami pasayan tayo. So there's no sense of sportiness with the way the steering feels. So there's no sense of like feedback whatsoever. But it is light. The steering feels light. There's a degree of stability when you drive straight, but as a result of that, when you go through corners, it doesn't feel as agile as what you would think, no? So I'm wiggling the wheel ngayon, and it's not as responsive as I would like, at least if I were looking for something sporty. But for the general population who looks for something that's comfortable, relaxing to drive, and stable, this is it. This Hyundai Stargazer feels like that MPV. So yeah, we're gonna go through more corners, and the suspension deals with body roll. I mean, sakto lang. There's body roll, but it's in a controlled manner. It's not dramatic whatsoever. So yeah, it's a comfortable MPV, not exactly what you would call sporty. And then, yes, as I mentioned, this has a CVT. It's ready to a 1.5-liter 4-cylinder engine. And, you know, it performs really well. There's a decent amount of pull. It's not class-leading in terms of horsepower, but it's enough. It's perfectly enough for your daily needs. So, in terms of power delivery, it's on the linear side of things. So, we're gonna... There's the rubber band-ish. Meron ka nung parang onting rubber band feel when you accelerate with the Hyundai Stargazer. But, for the most part, it performs really well. As for fuel economy, well, we cannot discuss that at this point kasi sa totoo lang, it only has driven 78 kilometers on the odometer, so this car hasn't even been broken and it's so new. And also, syempre, we're just driving here around the village, so as if naman, we're gonna be able to fully test its fuel economy at this point. So, and the suspension deals with bumps pretty well. It soaks up the bumps really well. But yeah, I'm actually looking forward to driving this thing out on longer drives, no? For the rest of the experience, the interior, the exterior, the features. And speaking of the features, the Hyundai Stargazer is one of those subcompact MPVs that is also setting the benchmark in terms of driving assistance tech. So you get the full beans such as automatic emergency braking, lane centering pa nga, as a matter of fact, not even just lane departure warning. It's lane centering, it's Hyundai's lane following assist. You also have blind spot warning, rear cross traffic alert, and the thing with Hyundai's blind spot warning is that if you start to turn the wheel, it will actually pull you back to your lane if there's a car talaga beside you. So not only is it a warning, but it will actually avoid you from hitting the car beside you altogether. Really amazing stuff. Then yeah, that makes the Hyundai Stargazer one of the best as well, yeah, in terms of safety and technology.
The Hyundai Stargazer will have an introductory base price of 998,000 pesos, with full pricing of all variants to be revealed on November 8. And for the full specs of each variant, you can simply head over to goflatoutph.com. Based on our first impressions, the Hyundai Stargazer is setting the benchmark in certain aspects in the subcompact MPV segment, most especially in terms of tech, design, and the amount of features you get for your money. More importantly, is how well integrated and cohesive all of these features work together, which is something you can say in most of its rivals that tend to be a mishmash of varying parts from various models, in a way, of course, to meet costs. We're keen to take the Hyundai Stargazer out on a longer drive. So continue sticking to GoFlatOutPH in order to be updated about the Hyundai Stargazer.